Today we're going to be upcycling a jean jacket, so I'm going to try to make these directions as easy as I possibly can. Today I'm going to be using my embroidery machine as well as the sewing portion of the embroidery machine, so if you have any questions, please let me know. I will try to provide the best step-by-step instructions that I can do, so just follow along. Plies is obviously going to be your jean jacket. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to be just jean. You know, you can do any jacket. I've seen upcycled vests. I've seen all types of stuff. So we are going to go ahead and get this started. And then, so let's just jump right in. So the first thing you're going to need is obviously your jean jacket. You can use a quilting ruler. I don't know where my quilting ruler is, only because my craft room looks like a bomb went off, per usual. So, I measured my design space. I'm going to try to stay within this rectangle shape. It might not happen, but we'll see. And so that's how I'm starting with this. I also got my main fabric. You can do just one color. I decided to do two colors because I'm going to give it a border on either side. So it's going to look... Basically, it's going to look something like that. I mean, I'm going to be pressing it and then I'm going to quilt it, but this is how I started. I did 3-inch strips of this and then I just cut down the main fabric to sizing, and also obviously with you want your seam allowance to be able to, because you're going to be sewing this as well. It's not just going to be embroidery. So... I feel like I'm going too fast, so if I am, please, if I didn't go over something well enough, please ask me a question or I'll make another video about it. So. All right, you can see we have it sewed up. So I'm going to turn it over. So you can either press them out or press them split the seam and press it. I'm just going to press it out because that's the way the fabric is naturally going. That's the way I would suggest that you do it, unless you're quilting, which then you obviously want your seams to nest. But, that's not what's happening right now. So. I'm gonna flip it over. Gonna make sure our seams over here are looking nice. Same thing with this one. You see the seam is already pushing out, so I'm just gonna go ahead and stick with that, ride with it, hit it with a little bit of this. All right, the next step is gonna be embroidery. So let's go ahead and get that ready and go from there. So I am going to use a full sheet of white felt. So I am going to take some basting spray. And I'm just going to spray it on it. Then I'm going to take my fabric. I'm going to try to center it as much as I can. Just going to spread it out. Beautiful. This is exactly what I wanted. Okay. Then I'm going to I'm a mess over here, guys. Take my embroidery hoop. I'm gonna put my tearaway stabilizer in there. I'm gonna give this another spray, even though I dropped my. Aha! I'm gonna give this another spray. Doop, 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 doop. Okay, now the next thing I'm gonna do, I am going to fold this in half and I'm gonna get a straight pin. Actually, I guess I should probably fold it in half this way. I'm gonna fold it in half this way so I know that it's directly in the half. I'm gonna put my straight pin in. That's centered. Now I'm gonna match it up to the notch on my embroidery hoop. Although, I also want it centered on this side too, right? So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm sorry I'm all over the place, guys, because like I said, I've never made one of these before, so we're kind of on this journey together. So I'm gonna center it here as well. I don't know if you can see that. So you're going to be centering both places. So I don't know if you guys know this, but there's a little notch right here. And there's also a notch right here. That's the center for horizontal, and this is the center for vertical. So since I have my two pins, I'm going to feel with my notch on this side, and then that looks pretty centered to me. What do you guys think? All right, so you want to smooth that out as much as you possibly can. You don't want there to be any wrinkles. You want the hoop. I'm going to take my pins out. Oh, I just stabbed myself. You're going to want the hoop and the fabric to be like one. So when you go like this and you feel it, A, it should be drum tight. See, it sounds like a drum. And then you want everything to be flush. If you don't, you will have puckering. I promise you, there will be puckering. All right, let's move back on. All right, so I pulled this baby off the embroidery machine. Looks pretty good, right? All right, so while it was embroidering, I went ahead and measured to see how big I actually wanted the design. So the finished design is gonna be 7.5 by 12. So there's gonna be about 1/2 inch on each side. So that's basically how it's going to look. There's going to be just a little bit on the tops. So you can see on the back, I used, I already pulled the tearaway away, but I used white felt to give it a little bit more rigidity, because when I start to quilt it, it's going to, you'll see, it's going to kind of almost look 3D. So I am going to trim. I'm going to pull this back to the seam. And then I'm just going to trim that with just my dress shears. Just because I think it'll help me get a better idea of how I need to sew my borders. Sorry for the awkward silence. Okay, so I didn't cut any of the fabric, I just cut the felt. So now that I have this, I'm gonna kind of just fold it over and see what it looks like. And then, actually, I kind of like the thin border, but I think I'm gonna pull it out just a wee bit. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna iron this, but also finger pressing works very well when you're doing stuff like this, because then you can just top stitch it. But I am gonna measure it because this side is a little bit weird. So I'm gonna come over here. I think I'm gonna do just an inch border. So that is about an inch. If I had a roller press, I would roll it, but I'm just gonna hit it with the iron here in a minute after I do the bottom. I'm actually gonna take a straight pin and put that in here just so I don't lose my Ooh, that was like a perfect fold. Good job, Linz. I talk to myself a lot when I'm crafting, so luckily there's no neighbors on either side of me. I mean, there is one over on that side of the apartment, but they probably think I was nuts. Most of the time I have music on, so I'm like singing and dancing and yelling at my machine. All right, so that is gonna be my top and bottom border. I think I'm going to quilt it first before I lob off the sides, because it will change the way the design looks. So I'm going to press these really quick just so I know where the lines are. Then I'm going to take the pins out, and then I'm going to start quilting. So you guys get ready for that. I'm very unorganized right now. Sorry, I apologize. I was gonna use an extra piece of batting on the back, but I think it's gonna be too bulky on the jacket. And the girl who I'm giving it to is petite, so I don't want her to, you know, feel all bogged up. So there is that. Now I'm gonna go over to my embroidery machine and reset up the camera. All right, so right now the machine is still in embroidery mode, so we're actually gonna switch it back to sewing mode. I've done this a couple times already in the video, so I'm just gonna make it quick, and I'll go ahead and fast forward this to you guys. I'm still trying to work on the camera angles. Yeah. So hopefully this makes sense to you and it's not like, what the heck is this girl doing? All right. All right, so I went ahead and changed the machine from embroidery to sewing. I just wanted to touch base on thread. So I'm gonna be using embroidery thread to sew. But you guys cannot use sewing machine thread to embroider, if that makes sense. You can go from a polyester to a cotton, but you can't go from a cotton to a polyester. If that makes sense. I hope it does. Little fun tips and tricks for you there. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and change my thread. I'm going to use red. I'm sure a true Ohio State fan is going to tell me that the color is not red, but it is today. So I'm just going to actually follow the design. I'm just going to try to stay about a half, probably a quarter inch away from each other. So stay tuned. I'm going to go ahead and speed this up and put my music on and get to work. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see this. I can't figure out how to get this thing to focus. Okay, so I quilted all around and then around, but I didn't want to quilt again only because of it was going to get cut. So I'm going to go ahead and trim this to the size that it needs to be. And then I think that's all I'm going to do for the quilting, honestly, because I think it looks great. I might do a couple horizontal, just boop, boop, really quick after I trim it. I think I'll do that. Okay, so I'm terrible at math. Shocker. But the problem is this fabric didn't stretch because of the embroidery design, but this other fabric stretched out. So here in the middle, 9 inches, which means 4.5 and 4.5. So that's really what I need to go off of. Looks pretty good to me, folks. All right, let's see how it looks on the jacket. Woo! She gonna be styling. All right. I'm gonna go ahead and sew these other areas really quickly. Okay, so I just had a moment. So I'm sewing this up, and I'm like, man, how am I going to stop the edges from fraying? So I was like, you know what? Forget about it. I'm going to make it a ragged up cycle. And then I was like, all right, well, the top, how am I going to get that to stay? Boom, I made it look like an O. I don't know if anyone else is amazed about this, but I sure am. So I'm going to go ahead and pin it to the back of the jacket so I can start sewing it. But I don't, this looks, man, I'm proud of myself. Like, I mean, yeah. Yep. 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 All right. I am going to pin this to the jacket, and then I'm going to sew it on. So, I'll see you guys shortly. Okay, listen, this came out so much better than I thought it was going to. I mean, I was expecting it to be cute, like, I'm not gonna lie, but this right here. Guys, how cute is that? I just bought a Buckeye, like, the little nuts. The felty pattern. So I think I'm going to put them on the lapels right here because I got to add some sass to this jacket. Because the girl who it's for is full of sass. Yeah, this jacket's for Joy. Her birthday's today. And I love her. So one of my good friends. So this jacket's for her. All my other friends, this came to me when I was walking through Goodwill. Okay, so I have it finished. I just texted her and asked if she wanted me to post a picture of it. She said no, she wants to be surprised. Ah! I'm the worst at surprises! Okay. So, I made Buckeye felties. I also, wow, that's crooked. It's just on a pin, so obviously I can, move it. And then I made, I think his name's Bucky. So they're on pins, so she can remove it or take it off or move it wherever she wants to. And then, here's the back. I hope she likes it. I also hope it fits. Upcycling was fun, I'm not gonna lie. I think I might do something for myself. I don't know what, but definitely something, and maybe I'll make a video of it. So thank you for watching my video. If you liked it, subscribe. I hope you liked it. I'm still figuring out, like I said, the cameras and such. So yeah, comment below if you have any suggestions or anything else you'd like me to make. I appreciate everybody tuning in, and